Once upon a time, I wish
in a far-off kingdom,
more than anything,
a fairy
more
maiden,
than life,
a sad young lad,
I wish,
and a childless baker,
more than life,
with his wife,
more than anything,
more than the moon,
I wish, the king is giving a festival,
more than life,
I wish to go to the festival,
more than riches,
I wish my cow would give us some milk,
more than anything, I wish we had a child,
I want a child,
I wish to go to the festival,
I wish we might have a child,
I wish.
To go to the festival.
The poor girl's mother had died.
You, Cinderella, the
what,
festival.
You, Cinderella, the
you
festival.
Wish to go to the festival.
The festival.
The king's festival.
And her father had taken for his new wife.
The festival.
A woman with two daughters of her own.
Look at your nails.
Look at your dress.
People would laugh at
but
you.
Nevertheless, I still wish to go to the festival and dance before the prince.
Vile and black of heart. Jack, on the other hand, had no father, and his mother,
I wish,
well, she's not quite as beautiful.
I wish my son were not a fool. I wish my house was not a mess. I wish the cow was full of milk. I wish the walls were full of gold. I wish a lot of things. You foolish child! What in heaven's name are you doing with a cow inside the house?
A warm environment might be just what Milky White needs to produce his milk.
It's a she. How many times do I have to tell you? Only she's can give milk.
Come in, little girl.
I wish. It's not for me, it's for my granny in the woods. A loaf of bread, please. To bring my poor old hungry granny in the woods. Just a loaf of bread, please.
Cinderella's stepmother had a surprise for her.
I have emptied a pot of lentils into the ashes for you. If you have picked them out again in 2 hours' time, then you shall go to the ball with us.
And perhaps a sticky bun or four.
Birds in the sky, birds in the eaves, in the leaves, in the fields, in the castles and ponds.
In the field of time,
come little birds, please. Down from the eaves and the leaves, over fields, out of castles and ponds.
No.
And peck, but swiftly sip through the ashes into the pot. Listen well, son. Milky White must be taken to market.
Mother, no, he's the best cow.
Was. She's been dry for a week. We've no food nor money and no choice but to sell her while she can still command a price.
The Milky White is my best friend in the whole world.
Look at her. There are bugs on her dugs. There are flies in her eyes. There's a lump on her rump big enough to be a hump.
But
son, we've no time to sit and dither while her withers wither wither. And no one keeps a cow for a friend. Sometimes I fear you're touched.
Into the woods, it's time to go. I hate to leave, I have to though. Into the woods, it's time, and so I must begin my journey. Into the woods and through the trees to where I am expecting them. Into the woods to grandmother's house. Into the woods to grandmother's house.
And you're certain of your way?
The way is clear, the light is good. I have no fear, nor no one should. The woods are just trees, the trees are just wood. I sort of hate to ask it, but do you have a basket?
Oh, don't stray and be late.
And save some of those sweets for Granny.
Into the woods and down the dell, the path is straight, I know it well. Into the woods and who can tell what's waiting on the journey. Into the woods to bring some bread to Granny, who is sick in bed. Never can tell what lies ahead, for all that I know, she's already dead. But into the woods, to grandmother's house and home before dark.
Fly, birds, back to the sky, back to the eaves and the leaves and the fields and the...
Hurry up and do my hair, Cinderella. Are you really wearing that?
You have a little tail, Cinderella. Can't you tie it with a hat?
You look beautiful.
I know.
She means me.
Put it in a twist.
We'll be there.
Mother said be good, father said be nice. That was always their advice. So be nice, Cinderella. Good, Cinderella. Nice, good, good, nice.
Tighter.
What's the good of being good if everyone is blind and you're always left behind? Never mind, Cinderella. Kind, Cinderella. Nice, good, nice. Kind, good, nice.
Ow! Not that tight.
I'm sorry.
Claude.
Because the baker lost his mother and father in a baking accident, at least that's what he believed, he was eager to start a family of his own and was concerned that all efforts until now had failed.
Who might that be?
We have sold our last loaf of bread.
Whoa, it's the witch from next door! We have no bread!
Of course you have no bread.
What do you wish?
It's not what I wish. It's what you wish. Nothing cooking in there now, is there?
The old enchantress went on to tell them how she'd placed a spell on their house.
Oh, what spell?
In the past, when you were no more than a babe, your father brought his young wife and you to this cottage. They were a handsome couple, but not handsome neighbors. You see, your mother was with child, and she had developed an unusual appetite. She took one look at my beautiful garden and told your father that what she wanted more than anything in the world was greens, greens, and nothing but greens. Parsley, peppers, cabbages, and celery, asparagus, and watercress, and fiddle ferns, and lettuce, he said, all right. But it wasn't quite, because I caught him in the autumn in my garden one night. He was robbing me, raping me, rooting through my rutabaga, raiding my arugula, and ripping up the rampion, my champion, my favorite. I should have laid a spell on him, right there. Could have turned him into stone. Or a dog, or a chair, or a But I let him have the rampion. I'd lots to spare in return, however. I said, fair is fair. You will let me have the baby that your wife will bear. Now we'll call it square.
I had a brother.
No. But you had a sister.
But the witch refused to tell him any more of his sister. Not even that her name was Rapunzel. She went on.
I thought I had been more than reasonable, and that we all might live happily ever after. But how was I to know what your father had also hidden in his pocket? You see, when I inherited that garden, my mother warned me I would be punished if I were ever to lose any of the beans.
Beans?
The special beans. I let him go. I didn't know he'd stolen my beans. I was watching him crawl back over the wall. And that bang, crash, and lightning flash. And well, that's another story. Never mind. Anyway, at last the big day came, and I made my claim. Oh, don't take away the baby, they shrieked and screeched. But I did, and I hit her. Well, she'll never be reached. Your father cried, and your mother died. And for extra measure, I admit it was a pleasure. I said, sorry, I'm still not mollified. And I laid a little spell on them. And you too, son. That your family tree would always be a barren one. So there's no more fuss, there's no more seeds in my garden thrive. You should see my nectarines. But I'm telling you the same I tell kings and queens. Don't ever, never, ever mess around with my greens. Especially the beans.
Now listen to me, Jack. Lead Milky White to market and fetch the best price you can. Take no less than 5 pounds.
Are you listening to me?
Yes.
Then how much are you to ask?
No more than 5 pounds.
Less than five.
Less than five.
Jack, 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 head in a sack. The house is getting colder. This is not the time for dreaming. Chimney stack, starting to crack. The mice are getting bolder. The floor's gone slack. Your mother's getting older. Your father's not back. And you can't just sit here dreaming pretty dreams. To wish and wait from day to day will never keep the wolves away. So into the woods, the time is now. We have to live, I don't care how. Into the woods to sell the cow, we must begin the journey. Straight to the woods and don't delay, we have to face the marketplace. Into the woods to journey's end.
Into the woods to sell a friend.
Someday you'll have a real pet, Jack.
A piggy?
Ugh.
Meanwhile, the witch, for purposes of her own, explained to the baker might lift the spell.
You wish to have the curse reversed?
Yes.
I'll need a certain potion first. Go to the wood and bring me back one, the cow as white as milk. Two, the cape as red as blood. Three, the hair as yellow as corn. And four, the slipper as pure as gold. Bring me these before the chime of midnight. 3 days' time, and you shall have, I guarantee, a child as perfect as child can be.
Thank you!
Thank you!
Go to the wood. Ha!
Ladies, our carriage awaits.
Now may I go to the festival?
The festival? Darling, those nails, darling, those clothes. Lentils are one thing, but darling, with those, you'd make us the fools of the festival and mortify the prince.
The carriage is waiting.
We must be gone.
Good night, father. I wish.
Oh, look what I found in father's hunting jacket.
6 beans.
Oh, yes. I wonder if they're...
The witch's beans? We'll take them with us.
No. You're not coming.
I know you're fearful of the woods and
night. No! The spell is on my house. Only I can lift the spell.
No, the spell is on our house. We must lift the spell together this morning.
You are not to come, and that is final. Now, what am I to return?
You don't remember? The cow is white as milk. The cape is red as blood. The hair is yellow as corn. The slipper is pure as gold.
The cow is white
and
as
so
milk.
The
cape is red as blood. The hair is yellow as corn.
Man.
The slipper is pure as gold.
Cinderella.
I still wish to go to the festival.
The cow is white as milk.
But how am I ever to get to the festival? I know I'll visit mother's grave, the grave at the hazel tree, and tell her I just wish to go to the king's festival.
Into the woods, it's time to go. It may be all in vain, I know. Into the woods, but even so, I have to take the journey. Into the woods, the path is straight. I know it well, but who can tell? Into the woods to lift the spell.
Into the woods to visit mother. Into the woods to fetch the things.
To make the potion.
To go to the festival.
Into the woods
without regret. The choice is made. The task is set.
Into the woods without forgetting why I'm on the journey. Into the woods to get our wish. I don't care how. The time is now.
Into the woods to sell the cow.
Woods to get the money.
Into the woods to lift the spell.
To make the potion.
To go to the festival.
The way is clear, the light is good. I have no fear, nor no one should. The woods are just trees, the trees are just wood. No need to be afraid there,
there's something in the glade there.
Into the woods without delay, but careful not to lose the way. Into the woods, who knows what may be lurking on the journey. Into the woods to get the thing that makes it worth the journeying. Into the woods
to see the king, to sell the cow.
To make the potion, to see, to sell, to get, to bring, to make, to lift, to go to the festival. Into the woods, into the woods, into the woods, and out of the woods, and home before dark.
Cinderella had planted a branch at the grave of her mother, and she had visited there so often. wept so much that her tears had watered until it became a handsome tree.
I've been good and I've been kind, Mother, doing only what I learned from you. Why then am I left behind, Mother? Is there something more that I should do? What is wrong with me, Mother? Something must be wrong. I wish...
What, child? Specify. Opportunity is not a lengthy visitor. And good fortune, like bad, can befall when least expected.
I wish...
Do you know what you wish? Are you certain what you wish is what you want? If you know what you want, then make a wish. Ask the tree, and you shall have your wish.
Shiver and quiver, little tree. Silver and gold throw down on me. I'm off to get my wish.
Quiet. Silence everywhere, Milky White. Not to my liking.
Hello, Jack.
How do you know my name?
When first I appear, I seem mysterious. But what explained, I'm nothing serious.
Say that again.
On your way to market? You might have been there long ago. Taking your time, Jack?
No, sir.
Is that true?
Well, you see, now I'm resting.
How much are you asking for the animal?
No less than 5 pounds, sir.
Now, Jack, why such a sum?
Well, my mother told me that
your
I should...
Your mother? A boy your age. Why, you'd be lucky to exchange her for a sack of beans.
Well, I... Come along, Milky White. There are spirits here.
Good day, young lady.
Good day, Mr. Wolf.
Whither away so hurriedly?
To my grandmother's.
And what might be in your basket?
Bread and wine, so grandmother will have something good to make her strong.
And where might your grandmother live?
A good quarter of a league further in the wood. Her house stands under 3 large oak trees.
Oh, look at that lush. Pink and plump. Hello, little girl. Tender and fresh, not one lump. Hello, little girl. This one's especially lush. Delicious! Hello, little girl, what's your rush? You're missing all the flowers. The sun won't set for hours. Take your time.
Mother said straight ahead, not to delay or be misled.
But slow, little girl, hark and hush. The birds are singing sweetly. You'll miss the birds completely. You're traveling so fleetly. Grandmother first, then Miss Plump. What a delectable combo. Utter perfection, one brittle, one supple, one moment.
Your mother said, come with me, follow the path and never stray.
Just so, little girl, many paths, so many worth exploring. Just one would be so boring. And look what you're ignoring. Think of those crisp, aging bones. Then something fresh on the palate. Think of that scrumptious carnality twice in one day. There's no possible way to describe what you feel when you're talking to your meal.
Mother said not to stray. Still, I suppose a small delay, granting my like a fresh. fresh bouquet. Goodbye, Mr. Wolf.
Goodbye, little girl. And hello.
It's time to come to that little girl in the red cape.
Forget the little girl, get the cape.
You frighten me.
That's the cape. Get it.
How am I supposed to get it?
You go up to the little thing and you take it.
Well, I can't just take a cloak from a little girl. Why don't you take it?
If I could, I would, but I...
Oh, my Rapunzel. Listen to her beautiful music.
Get me what I need. Get me what I need! Ha!
Oh, this is ridiculous. I'll never find that red cape, nor find a golden cow or a yellow slipper. Was it a golden slipper and a yellow cow? Oh, no.
The cow is white as milk, the cape is red as blood, the hair is yellow as corn, the slipper is pure as gold.
Oh, what are you doing here?
You forgot your scarf.
Oh, no, no, you have no business being alone in the wood. And you have no idea what I have come upon here. You would be frightened for your life. And now go home immediately.
I wish to help.
No! The spell is on my house.
Our house.
Only I can lift the spell. The spell is on my house.
Together, the spell is on... A cow is white as...
Milk. Well, hello there, young lad.
Hello, sir.
What might you be doing with a cow in the middle of the forest?
Well, I was heading toward market, but I seem to have lost my way.
And what were you planning to do?
And what were you planning to do there?
Sell my cow, sir. No less than 5 pounds.
5 pounds? Where am I to get 5 pounds?
She must be generous of milk to fetch 5 pounds.
Yes, ma'am.
And if you can't fetch that sum, then what are you to do?
I hadn't thought of that. I suppose my mother and I will have no food to eat.
Oh, this is the sum total.
Beans? Beans! We mustn't give up our beans! Well, if you feel we must.
Huh?
Beans will bring you food, son.
Beans? In exchange for my cow?
Oh, these are no ordinary beans, son. These beans carry magic.
Magic? What kind of magic?
Tell him.
Magic that defies description.
My mother wouldn't really
You'd
like
You'd be me. Lucky to exchange her for a sack of beans.
How many beans?
Six.
No, 5. We can't part with all of them. We must save one for ourselves. Besides, I'd say they're worth a pound each at the very least.
Could I buy my cow back someday?
Possibly. Well, good luck there, young lad.
I guess this is goodbye, old pal. You've been a perfect friend. I hate to see us part, old pal. Someday I'll buy you back. I'll see you soon again. I hope that when I do, won't be on a plate.
Take the cow and go home.
I was trying to be helpful.
Oh, magic beans. We've no reason to believe they're magic. Are we to dispel this curse through deceit?
No one would have given him more for this creature. Besides, we did them a favor. At least they'll have some food.
Oh, 5 beans.
If you know what you want, then you go and you find it and you get it.
Home.
Do we want a child or not? And you give and you take and you bid and you bargain or you live to regret it.
Will you please go home?
There are rights and wrongs and in-betweens. No one waits when fortune intervenes. And maybe they're really magic. Who knows? Why you do what you do, that's the point. All the rest of it is chatter.
Look at her, she's crying.
If the thing you do is pure in intent, if it's meant, if it's just a little bent, does it matter?
Yes.
No, what matters is that everyone tells tiny lies. What's important really is the size. Only three more tries, then we'll have our prize. When the end's in sight, you'll realize if the end is right, it justifies the beans.
Take the cow and go home, and I will carry this out in my own fashion.
And so the baker continued his search for the cape as red as blood. As for Rapunzel, the witch was careful not to lose this beauty to the outside world, and so shut her within a doorless tower that lay deep within the forest. And when the old enchantress paid a visit, she called forth.
Rapunzel!
Let your hair down to me.
Rapunzel. Rapunzel. What a strange name. Strange but beautiful, and fit for a prince. Tomorrow, before that horrible witch arrives, I will stand beneath her tower and ask her to let her hair down to me.
Well, hello there, little one.
Hello.
Have you saved some of those sweets for Granny?
I ate all the sweets. And half a loaf of bread.
Where did you get that beautiful cape? I so admire it.
My granny made it for me.
Oh, is that so? I would love a red cloak like that.
You look pretty foolish.
May I take a look at it?
I don't like to be without my cape. Please give it back.
I want it badly.
Give it back, please.
I just wanted to make certain you really loved this cape. And now you go off to Granny's and be sure no wolf comes your way.
I'd rather a wolf than you any day. Oh!
If you know what you need, then you go and you find it and you take it. Well, do I want a child or not? It's a cloak. What's a cloak? It's a joke. It's a stupid little cloak. And a cloak is what you make it. So you take it. Things are only what you need them for. What's important is who needs them more.
And so the baker, with newfound determination, went after the girl with the red cape. As for the little girl, she's surprised to find her grandmother's cottage door standing open.
Oh dear, how uneasy I feel. Perhaps it's all the sweets. Good day, Grandmother. My grandmother, you're looking very strange. What big ears you have.
The better to hear you with, my dear.
But Grandmother, what big eyes you have.
The better to see you with, my dear.
But Grandmother, what large hands you have.
The better to hug you with, my dear.
Oh, Grandmother, what a terrible big wet mouth you have!
The better to eat you with, my dear!
And scarcely had the wolf said this than with a single bound he was devouring the little girl. Well,
It was a full day of eating for both. And with his appetite appeased, the wolf took to bed for a nice long nap.
That grandmother has a mighty snore. Odd. Where is the little one? Eating, no doubt. Or eaten! Oh, grandmother! Ha! Oh, what is that piece of red cloth hanging out of the corner of your mouth? It seems to me to be... Aha! I'll get the cape from within your stomach!
You the lucky one. Now, whatever are you doing in the wood at this hour?
Oh, no. I hear a spell over here.
Shh. Miss?
Have you seen a beautiful young maiden in a ball gown pass through?
I don't think so, sir. I think I see her over there. I've never lied to royalty before. I've never anything to royalty before.
Oh, thank you.
If a prince were looking for me, I certainly wouldn't hide.
Well, what brings you here? And with a cow?
Oh, my husband's somewhere in the woods. He's undoing a spell.
Oh!
Now the prince, what was he like?
He's a very nice prince.
And?
It's a very nice ball.
And?
When I entered, they trumpeted.
And? The prince?
Oh, the prince?
Yes, the prince.
Well, he's tall.
Is that all? Did you dance? Is he charming? They say that he's charming.
We did nothing but dance.
Yes. And?
And it made a nice change.
No, the prince.
Oh, the prince?
Yes, the prince.
He has charm for a prince, I guess.
Guess?
I don't need a wide range, and it's all very strange.
Are you to return to the festival tomorrow week?
Perhaps.
Perhaps. Oh, to be pursued by a prince. All that pursues me is tomorrow's bread. What I wouldn't give to be in your shoes.
Will you look over there? An enormous vine growing next to that little cottage.
I mean, slippers.
It looks like a beanstalk rising into the sky.
As pure as gold.
We must get home.
Wait, wait, I need your shoes. No, get back here.
One midnight gone.
Every night. One sweet rope.
Sometimes the things you most wish for are not to be touched.
The harder to get, the better to have.
Agreed.
Agreed.
Never wear mauve but a ball.
Or pink.
Or open your mouth. The difference between a cow and a bean can begin an adventure.
Slotted spoons don't hold much soup.
The prettier the flower, the farther from the path.
The closer to the family, the closer to the wine.
One midnight gone.
The mouth of the wolf, not the end of the world.
A steward is not just a dog to a prince.
Opportunity is not a lengthy visitor.
You may know what you need, but to get what you want, better see that you keep what you have.
One midnight gone!
Sometimes the things you most wish for are not to be touched.
Better see that you keep what you have.
One midnight gone! One midnight gone! Into the woods! Into the woods! Into the woods! Out of the woods! Home before!
There are giants in the sky. There are big, tall, terrible giants in the sky. You're way up high and you look below at the world you left and the things you know. Little more than a glance is enough to show you just how small you are. When you're way up high and you're on your own in a world like none that you've ever known, where the sky is lead and the earth is stone, you're free to do whatever pleases you, exploring things you never dare, cause you don't care when suddenly there's a big, tall, terrible giant at the door. Tall, terrible lady giant sweeping the floor. But she gives you food and she gives you rest, and she draws you close to her giant breast, and you know things now that you never knew before. Not till the sky. Only just when you made a friend and all, and you know she's big but you don't feel small, someone bigger than her comes along the hall to swallow you for lunch. And your heart is lead and your stomach's stone, and you're really scared being all alone. And it's then that you long for the things you've known, and the world you left and the little you own. The fun is done, you steal what you can and run. And you scramble down and you look below, and the world you know begins to grow. The roof, the house, and your mother at the door. The roof, the house, and the world you never thought to explore. And you think of all of the things you've seen, and you wish that you could live in between. And you're back again, only different than before.
after the sky. There are giants in the sky. There are big, tall, terrible, awesome, scary, wonderful giants in the sky. Good fortune, sir. Look what I have. Here are 5 gold pieces.
Whoa, 5 gold pieces?
I had more, but my mother made me surrender them. She allowed me these 5 to do it as I pleased.
Oh, my.
Where is Milky White?
Milky White is back home with my wife.
Let's go get them.
Oh, wait! I don't know that I wish to sell.
But you said I might buy her back.
I know, but I'm not sure that
Are you saying you wish more money?
More money is always...
Take these. I'll go get more.
Wait! Wait, I didn't say. Woohoo! Ooh, 5 gold pieces! Oh, with this money I could buy baking supplies for a year. I could buy a new thatched roof and a new chimney.
But could you buy yourself a child?
Who are you?
When first I appear, I seem delirious. But when explained, I'm nothing serious. Could you buy yourself a child?
Oh, I don't understand.
How badly do you wish a child? 5 gold pieces? 10? 20?
Hadn't thought to put a price on it.
Exactly. You've not thought about much now, have you, son?
Give that back! That's not yours!
Nor is it checks. The money's not what's important. What's important is that your wish be honored.
Now come back here! Oh, what are you doing here now?
I see you have the red cape!
Oh, yes, I've the cape. I've only 2 of the 4.
You've the cape!
What have you done with the cow?
She ran away. I never reached home. I've been looking for her all night.
I should have known better than to have entrusted her with you.
She might just as easily have run from you.
Yeah, but she didn't.
But she might have.
Yeah, but she didn't.
Who cares? The cow is gone. Get it back. Get it back.
We were just going to do that. Here, I can give you this.
Don't give me that, fool. I don't want to touch that. Have you no sense?
Listen to her beautiful music.
Lovely.
She's very gifted.
By tomorrow's midnight, deliver the items or you wish you never thought to have yourself a child. Ha! Ooh. Ha!
Oh. I don't like that woman.
I'm sorry I lost the cow.
I shouldn't have yelled. Now please, go back to the village. I will sort all of this out, and then we can just go about our business. And no more prancing through the woods for strange objects. And no more witches or dim-witted boys or hungry little girls. Go!
Ah, there you are, good brother. Father and I had wondered where you had gone.
I have been looking all night for her.
Her?
The beautiful one I danced the evening with.
Where did she go?
Disappeared, like the fine morning mist.
She was lovely?
The loveliest.
I am not certain of that. I must confess, I too have found a lovely maiden. She lives here, in the woods.
The woods?
Yes, in the top of a tall tower. That has no door or stairs.
Where?
Just 2 leagues from here, just beyond the mossy knoll.
And how do you manage a visit?
I stand beneath her tower and say, Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair to me. And she lowers the longest, most beautiful head of hair, yellow as corn, which I climb to her.
Rapunzel! Rapunzel? What kind of name is that? Surely you jest. I have never heard of such a thing.
I speak the truth. She's as true as your maiden. A maiden running from a prince? None would run from us.
Yet, one has. Did I abuse her or show her disdain? Why does she run from me? If I should lose her, how shall I regain the heart she has won from me?
Haggerty, beyond power of speech, when the one thing you want is the only thing out of your reach.
High in her tower, she sits by the hour, maintaining her hair. Life and becoming and frequently humming a light-hearted air. Ah, agony far more painful than yours, when you know she would go with you if there only were doors.
Agony, all the torture they teach
was as intriguing
or half so fatiguing
as what's out of reach.
Am I not sensitive, clever, well-mannered, considerate, passionate, charming, as kind as I'm handsome, an heir to a throne?
You are everything maidens could wish for.
Then why no?
Do I know?
The girl must be mad.
You know nothing of madness till you're climbing her hair and you see her up there as you're nearing her, all the while hearing her.
Misery, well, no, it's different for each. Oh, it's 10 steps behind.
Always 10 feet below.
And she's just out of reach.
Agony that can cut like a knife.
I must have her to.
Princess, each more handsome than the other. No, 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 get the hair.
Oh, excuse me, young woman. Have you encountered a boy with carrot-top hair and a sunny, though occasionally vague, disposition answering to the name of Jack?
Not the one partial to a white cow.
He is the one.
Have you seen the cow?
No, and I don't care to ever again. Children can be very queer about their animals. You be careful with your children now.
I have no children.
Oh, that's okay too.
Yes, well, I'm sorry, but I haven't seen your son today.
Oh, I hope he didn't go up that beanstalk again. Quit while you're ahead, I say. Jack! Jack!
Mo! Mo!
For your cow.
Oh, where did you find her? Hello?
What are you doing?
I'm here to make amends.
I want you to stay out of this, old man.
I'm here to see your wish granted.
You've caused enough trouble already. Keep out of my path. Ha!
To me.
Is that you? My prince?
Yes. Excuse me for this.
Ow! Ow!
No! No! plenty of spills, don't you?
It's these slippers. They're not much suited for these surroundings. Actually, they're not much suited for dancing either.
I'd say these slippers were as pure as gold.
Oh yes, they are all you could wish for in beauty.
What I wouldn't give for just one.
Well, one isn't likely to do you much good.
Was the ball just as wonderful as last evening?
Oh, it's still a nice ball.
Yes. And?
And they have far too much food.
No, the prince.
Oh, the prince.
Yes, the prince.
If he knew who I really was.
Oh, who?
I'm afraid I was rude.
Oh, how?
Now I'm being pursued.
Yes, and?
And I'm not in the mood.
He must really have taken a liking to you.
Yes, but I have no experiences with princes and castles and gowns.
Nonsense. Every girl dreams of
Look,
such things.
Sir!
I must run.
And I must have your shoe. Oh,
sweet, stop that!
I needed to have a child.
I needed to get out of here!
Where did she go?
Who?
Don't play the fool, woman.
Oh, you mean that lovely young maiden in a ball gown? She went that direction. You see, I was trying to hold her here for you, and I just...
I can capture my own damsel. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Where did he go? Who?
The prince, of course.
Yes. Oh, they went that direction, but you'll never reach them.
Well, we would have if that mongrel with the cow hadn't molested us.
Cow?
Oh, please! Please! Oh, if I could just compare this color to that of your own!
He wants to compare our hair to corn.
Over there!
I thought you were returning home. I've had no luck.
You've the cow!
Oh, yes, I've the cow. I'm only two of the four.
Three.
Two.
Three. Compare this to your corn.
Oh, where did you find it?
I pulled it from a maiden in a tower.
Oh, three!
And I almost had the fourth, but she got away.
Oh, we've one entire day left. Surely we can locate the slipper by then.
We? You mean you'll allow me to stay?
Well, perhaps it will take the two of us to get this child.
You've changed. You're daring. You're different in the woods. More sure, more sharing. You're getting us through the woods. If you could see, you're not the man who started, and much more open-hearted than I knew you to be.
It takes two. I thought one was enough. It's not true. It takes two of us. You came through. When the journey was rough, it took you. It took two of us. It takes care. It takes patience and fear and despair to change. Do you swear to change? You can tell if you do. It takes two.
You've changed. You're thriving. There's something about the woods, not just surviving. You're blossoming in the woods. At home, I'd fear we'd stay the same forever. And then out here, you're passionate, charming, considerate, clever.
It takes one to begin, but then once you've begun, it takes two of you, it's no fun. But what needs to be done, you can do. When there's two of you, if I dare, it's because I'm becoming aware of us. As a pair of us, each accepting a share of what's there.
We've changed, we're strangers. I'm meeting you in the woods. Who minds? What dangers? I know we'll get past the woods. And once we're past, Let's hope the changes last. Beyond woods, beyond witches and slippers and hoods, just the two of us beyond lies, safe at home with our beautiful prize. Just the few of us, it takes trust. It takes just a bit more and we're done. We want four, we had none, we've got three. We need one, it takes two.
Stop her! Stop that hen! Oh, Providence, my milky white! And the owners? And my hen?
Oh, look what this hen has just dropped in my hand!
A golden egg! I've never seen a golden egg!
You see? I promised you more than the 5 gold pieces I gave you, sir.
5 gold pieces?
No, I'm taking my cow.
No, I never said I would sell.
But you took the 5 gold pieces.
You took 5 gold pieces?
I didn't take, you gave.
Where are the 5 gold pieces?
When old man
came. You said I could have my cow.
No, I didn't say you could, I said you might.
You would take money before a child!
Milky White is dead!
Two!
Two midnights gone!
Wanting a ball is not wanting a prince.
Here may be better than far, but it still isn't there.
Here may be better than far, but it still isn't there.
The ball.
So near.
The ball.
You can never love somebody else's child.
2 minutes gone.
The way you love.
So near.
Your own.
The prince.
So far.
The greatest prize often lies at the end of the thorniest path.
2 minutes
gone. 2 minutes. 2 minutes gone. 2 minutes gone. The exhausted baker and his wife buried the dead Milky White.
Oh, you must go to the village in search of another cow.
And what do you propose I use to purchase this cow?
Here, tell them it's magic.
No person with a brain larger than this is going to exchange a cow for a bean.
Well, then steal it.
Steal it? Just 2 days ago, you were accusing me of exercising deceit and securing the cow.
Oh, then don't steal it. And resign yourself to a child this life.
Find it best. You go for the cow, as I've met a maiden with a golden slipper these previous eves, and I think I might succeed in winning one of her shoes.
Oh, fine.
Fine.
Simply...
Fine.
Unfortunately for Rapunzel, the witch discovered her affections for the prince before he could spirit her away.
What did I clearly say? Children must listen.
No, please.
What were you not to do? Children must see
and
learn. Why could you not obey? Children don't listen. What have I been to you? What would you have me be? Handsome like a prince?
Ashamed of me.
No, you are ashamed.
You don't understand.
It was lonely atop that tower.
I was not company enough.
I am no longer a child. I wish to see the world.
Don't you know what's out there in the world? Someone has to shield from the world. Stay with me. Princes wait there in the world, it's true. Princes, yes, but wolves and humans too.
Stay at home. Supply.
gave you protection, yet you disobeyed me.
Did you think I would stay in that tower forever?
You lied. Why didn't you tell me you had a visitor? I will not share you, but I will show you a world you've never seen.
Ha! No! No!
When is a white cow not a white cow?
Oh, I don't know. Leave me alone.
Haven't I left you alone long
enough? Your questions make no sense, old man. Go away.
In need of another cow.
What a beautiful cape.
Stay away from my cape or I'll slice you into 1,000 bits.
I don't want it. I was just admiring it.
My granny made it for me from a wolf that attacked us. And I got to skin the animal. And best of all, she gave me this beautiful knife for protection.
Well, look what I have. A hen that lays golden eggs.
I don't believe that egg came from that hen. Where did you get that egg?
I stole this from the kingdom of the giant, up there. And if you think this is something, you should see the golden harp the giant has. It can play the most beautiful tunes without you even having to touch it.
Of course it does. Why don't you go up to the kingdom and bring it back and show me?
I could.
You could not.
I could.
You could not, Mr. Liar.
I am not a liar. I'll get that harp. You'll see.
After having cast out Rapunzel to a remote desert, the witch returned to take the prince by surprise, and as he leapt from the tower, the thorns into which he fell in pierced his eyes and blinded him. As for Cinderella, she returned from a final visit to the festival.
He's a very smart prince. He's a prince who prepares. Knowing this time I'd run from him, he spread pitch on the stairs. I was caught unawares, and I thought, well, he cares. This is more than just malice. Better stop and take stock while you're standing here stuck on the steps of the palace. You think, what do you want? You think, make a decision. Why not stay and be caught? You think, well, it's a thought. What would be his response? But then what if he knew who you were when you know that you're not what he thinks that he wants? But then what if you are what a prince would envision? Although how can you know who you are till you know what you want, what you don't? So then which do you pick? Where you're safe, out of sight in yourself, but where everything's wrong. Or where everything's right and you know that you'll never be long. And whichever you pick, do it quick, cause you're starting to stick to the steps of the palace. It's your first big decision. The choice isn't easy to make. To arrive at a bold is exciting and old. You're there though it's scary. And it's fun to deceive when you know you can leap, but you have to be wary. There's a lot that's at stake, but you've stalled long enough, cause you're still standing stuck to the stuff on the steps. Better run along home and avoid the collision. Even though they don't care, you'll be better off there, where there's nothing to choose, so there's nothing to lose. So you pry up your shoes, and from out of the blue, and without any guide, you know what your decision is, which is not to decide. You'll just leave him a clue, for example, a shoe, and then see what he'll do. Now it's he and not you who is stuck with a shoe, in a stew, in the goo. And you've learned something too, something you never knew, on the steps of the palace.
No, 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 do not come any closer to me.
Just hear me out.
You have attacked me once before. We have nothing to discuss.
I did not attack you. I attacked your shoe. I need it. Here. Here's a magic bean in exchange for it.
A magic bean?
Oh, nonsense.
Oh, don't do that!
I've already lost one shoe this evening. My feet cannot bear to give up another.
I need that shoe to have a child.
Well, that makes no sense.
Does it make sense that you're running from a prince?
Stop!
Here, take my shoes. You'll run faster.
Who was that woman?
I do not know, sir.
Lying will cost you your life.
I've done nothing wrong. I was simply having a conversation. You can...
I've the cow!
The slipper! We vote for...
I will bring this to the prince, and we will search the kingdom for the maiden who will fit this shoe.
It's mine. I don't care if this costs me my life.
Give her the slipper, and all will come.
What was that noise?
Sir, just a bolt of lightning in a far-off kingdom.
How dare you take off and search without me?
My apologies, sir. I just thought that I might...
Enough of what you thought. I employed a ruse and had the entire staircase smeared with pitch. And there, when she ran off, remained the maiden's slipper.
Brilliant!
I thought so. It did create quite a mess when the other guests left.
And sir, I have succeeded in obtaining the other slipper.
Give her the slipper, and all will come to a happy end.
Who are you, old man?
When first I appear, I seem deleterious, but when explained...
Shut up.
Do as he says. He's obviously a spirit of some sort, and we only need one.
Yes.
There's a dead giant in my backyard! I heard Jack coming down the beanstalk, calling for his axe. And when he got to the bottom, he took it and began hacking down the stalk. Suddenly, the beanstalk fell, but there was no Jack. And for all I know, he's been crushed by the ogre!
Worrying will do you no good. If he's safe, then he's safe. If he's been crushed, well then, there's nothing any of us can do about that, is there? We must be off. I need my rest before tomorrow's search is to commence.
Doesn't anyone care that a giant has fallen from the sky?
He is dead, is he not?
Well, with such a thought, I would suppose.
The third midnight is here. You've all the objects.
Yes. Slipper, hair.
Oh, cape, cow!
That cow doesn't look white as milk to me.
Oh, she is. She is.
This cow has been covered in flour.
Well, we did have a cow as white as milk, honestly, we did.
Then where is she?
She's dead.
We thought you prefer a live cow.
Of course I'd prefer a live cow. So bring me the dead cow and I'll bring her back to life.
Well, you could do that.
Now! Ha!
Oh, there you are. Oh, I've been worried sick.
Mother, look, the most beautiful harp.
You've stolen too much. You could have been killed coming down that plant.
She's too heavy.
What's happening?
Milky White! Now I have two friends, a cow and a harp.
Quiet. Feed the objects to the cow.
What?
You heard me. Feed them to the cow.
Fill this.
I'll do it. She'll only milk for me. Squeeze, pal.
Wrong ingredients.
Forget about a child.
No, wait. We followed your instructions. One, that cow is as white as milk, correct?
Yes.
And two, that cape was certainly as red as blood.
Yes.
And three, the slipper?
Yes.
And four, I compared that hair to this ear of corn.
I pulled it from a maiden in a tower.
You what? What were you doing there?
Well, I happened to be passing by, so I
touched that hair. Don't you understand? I cannot have touched the ingredients.
No!
The corn!
What?
Pull the silky hair from the corn and feed it to the cow, quickly!
This had better work, old man, before the last stroke of midnight, or your son will be the last of your flesh and blood.
Son?
He's not now.
Yes, meet your father.
Father? Could that be you? I thought you died in a baking accident.
I didn't want to run away from you, son.
It's working!
He's milking!
I don't understand.
Not now. It's in the cup.
Oh, no. We've given you what you wish.
Now, when can we expect a child?
Oh, what's wrong?
What's happening?
Oh, where are you going?
Son!
Father!
All is repaired.
He's dead!
And so the mysterious man died, having helped end the curse on his house. For the baker, there would be no reunion with his father, and he and his wife, bewildered, returned home. The witch, who had been punished with age and ugliness that night when the beans had been stolen and the lightning flashed, was reunited to her former state of youth and beauty. And Milky White, after a night of severe indigestion, was returned to the now wealthy Jack. As for Prince, he began his search for the foot to fit the golden slipper. And when he came to Cinderella's house, the stepmother took the slipper into Florinda's room.
Careful, my toe.
Darling, I know.
What'll we do?
It'll have to go. But when you're his bride, you can sit or ride. You'll never need to walk.
The girl obeyed and swallowed her pain and joined the prince on his horse, riding off to become his bride.
Get the blood within the shoe. This is not the proper bride for you. Look, search for the foot that fits.
The prince returned the false bride and asked the other sister to try on the shoe.
Why won't it fit?
Darling, be still. Cut off a bit of the heel and it will. And when you're his wife, you'll have such a life. You'll never need to walk.
The girl obeyed, swallowing her pain, and joined the prince on his horse to become his bride. But as the sister was helped on the horse by the prince, he noticed the blood trickling from the shoe.
Have you no other daughters?
To which the woman replied,
no, only a little stunted kitchen wench, which his late wife left behind. But she is far too dirty, she cannot show herself.
I insist.
And when Cinderella presented herself and tried on the blood-soaked slipper, it fit like a glove.
This is the true bride.
I have always wanted a son.
Much to the dismay of the stepmother and her daughters, Cinderella joined the prince on his horse and became the prince's bride.
No, but it all within the shoe. This is the proper bride for you. Fit to attend a prince.
And finally, as for Cinderella, she bore twins and lived impoverished in the desert until the day her prince, wandering aimlessly, heard a voice so familiar that he went towards it. Rapunzel, overjoyed at seeing him, fell into his arms weeping. Two of her tears wetted his eyes, and their touch restored his vision.
I was going to come fetch you as soon as you learned your lesson.
Who are you?
Surely you remember.
Mother?
This is who I truly am. Come with me, child, and we can be happy as we once were.
She will not go with you.
Let her speak for herself. You are the only family I know. Come with me, please. You leave me no choice. Ha!
As is often the way in these tales, in exchange for her youth and beauty, the witch lost her powers over others. When the wedding with the prince was celebrated, Lucinda and Florinda attended the witch to win favor with Cinderella. And as the sisters stood by the blessed couple, pigeons swooped down and poked out their eyes, punishing them with blindness.
I see your prince has found you.
Yes.
Thank you for the slipper.
I didn't think I'd wed a prince.
I didn't think I'd ever find you.
I didn't think I could be so happy.
And it came to pass that all that seemed wrong was now right. The kingdoms are filled with joy, and those who deserve to return to a long and happy life.
Ever after!
Journey over, all's mended. And it's not just for today, but tomorrow, and extended. Ever after! All the curses have it ended. The reverse is wiped away. All is tenderness and laughter for forever after.
Happy now and happiness and happy ever after.
We're frightened,
but we hit it.
It's past, locked, and swerved.
We did not. It's amazing that we did it.
Now
we reach
the right conclusions.
And we got what we deserve. Not a sigh and not a sorrow, tenderness and laughter. Joy today and bliss tomorrow and forever after.
I was greedy.
I was vain.
I was haughty. We were happy.
It was fun.
But we were blind. Then we went into the woods to get our wish and now we're really blind.
I was perfect. I had everything but beauty. I had power. I had a daughter like a flower in a tower. Then I went into the woods to get my wish and I'm ordinary.
We were unworthy.
My flower.
I'm happy now. I'm happy. And as well as ever after. And we used our common sense, been worthy of our discontents to be happy. And forever, you must see your wish come true.
Don't be careful, don't be clever, when you see your wish pursue. It's a dangerous endeavor, but the only thing to do.
Though it's fearful, though it's deep, though it's dark, and though you may lose the path, though you may not go.
Though it's deep, you must
stop, you must stop, you must stop,
you must
stop.
Take the journey into the woods and down the dell in vain, perhaps, but who can tell? Into the woods to lift the spell,
into the woods to lose the longing,
into the woods to have the child,
to wed the prince,
to get the money,
to save the house,
to kill the wall,
to find the father,
conquer the kingdom,
to have, to wed, to get, to save, to kill, to keep, to go to the festival, into the woods, into the woods, into the woods, and out of the woods.
Thank you.
time. Later.
I wish
in that same far off kingdom
more than anything
lived a young princess, the lad Jack,
footman,
and the baker and his family.
No, I miss.
I wish
more than anything
more than the moon.
There.
I wish to sponsor a festival.
More than life.
The time has come for a festival.
More than riches.
And a ball. I miss my kingdom up in the sky.
More than anything.
I wish we had more
room. Another room.
But despite some minor inconveniences, they were all quite content.
I never thought I'd wed a prince.
I never thought I'd find perfection.
I never thought I could be so happy. Not an unhappy moment since.
I didn't think we'd be this rich.
To conceive of all of
that. I never thought we'd have a babe.
I never thought I could be so happy.
Happy now, happy hence, happy ever after. We're so happy, you're so happy. Just as long as you stay happy.
My cow.
Little gurgle.
Darling, I must go now.
We should really sell it.
Where's the cheesecloth?
Wishes may bring problems such as you regret them. Better that though than to never get them. I'm going to be a perfect wife.
I'm going to be a perfect
mother. I'm going to be a perfect father.
I'm going to see that he is so happy. I never thought I'd love my life.
Fortune smiled, I'm so happy. If only this cottage were a little larger.
Oh, I will expand our quarters in due time.
Why expand when we can simply move to another cottage?
Oh, we will not move. This was my father's house, and now it will be my son's.
You would raise your child alongside a witch?
Why does he always cry when I hold him?
Babies cry, he's fine. You needn't hold him as if he were so fragile.
He wants his mother.
I can't take care of him all the time.
I will take care of him when he is older. We had to go through thick and thin.
We had to lose a lot to win. I ventured out and saw within. I never thought I'd be so much I hadn't been.
Right.
Yes, I think so.
And the baby.
Yes, he's fine. Are you all right?
Oh, you! Have you done this to our house?
Always thinking of yourself. Look at my garden.
What of your garden?
Look!
Oh, I'm destroyed.
What has happened?
I was thrown to the ground. I saw nothing.
What could do such a thing?
Oh, an earthquake.
No earthquake. My garden has been trampled. Those are footprints.
Who could do such a thing?
Anything that leaves a footprint that large is no who.
Do you think it was a bear?
A bear? Bears are sweet. Besides, you ever see a bear with 40-foot feet?
A dragon?
No scorch marks. Usually they're linked.
Manticore?
Imaginary.
Griffin?
Extinct?
Giant?
Possible. Very, very possible.
Oh, a giant!
Perhaps we should tell somebody.
Who are you gonna tell?
Why, the royal family, of course!
The royal family? I wouldn't count on that family to snuff out a rat. With a giant, we'll all have to go to battle. A giant's the worst! A giant has a brain! It's hard to outwit a giant. A giant is just like us, only bigger. Much, much bigger. So big that we are just an expendable bug beneath its foot. crunch. We are moving.
And so the baker proceeded to the castle, but not before visiting the lad Jack in his mother's house.
Look, Milky White, it's the butcher.
Oh, the baker.
Baker.
What can we do for you, sir?
I'm here investigating the destruction that was wrought upon our house today.
Jack has been home with me all day.
The baker told Jack and his mother that he feared there was a giant in the land.
I can recognize a giant's footsteps. I can
go
with
you to
no
such thing.
Well, any help at
all? I'm sorry, but you'll get none from us. No one cared when there was a giant in my backyard. I don't remember you coming to my aid.
A giant in your backyard is one thing. A crushed home is quite another.
Look, young man. Giants never strike the same house twice. I wouldn't worry.
I'm taking the news to the castle nonetheless.
When the baker reached the castle, it was the princess who greeted his news. The story unfolds.
Excuse me, madam. This peasant insists on seeing you.
Princess, I've come to report the appearance of a giant in the land.
Where did you see a giant?
Oh, well, I didn't exactly see it.
Then how do you know there is a giant in the land?
Oh, my home has been crushed, and there are footprints.
That could have been caused by any number of things. I will show you to the door.
Wait.
A nearby household was visited by a giant not long ago, descending from a beanstalk.
Yes, I remember.
That giant was slain. Come along now.
Oh, wait! Oh, princess, please. Oh, we have a young child. Oh, a child is very difficult to come by. His safety is of great importance to me.
Are we entirely through now?
Yes.
I will take this news up with the prince when he returns. Thank you!
I'm going off to sell the harp, Jack.
Mother, no!
Jack, we don't want this harp around here when there's a giant on the loose.
But I know how to kill a giant.
Please, we've had our fill of giants.
Mother, if I could just help.
Enough! Promise me, son, you won't leave your surroundings.
Mother, I'm a man now.
You're still a little boy in your mother's eyes. I want you to promise. Promise.
Ow!
Promise!
I promise.
What happened to your house?
We've had a baking accident.
A baking accident?
No use frightening the young thing.
Well, you can't frighten her.
Well, I guess Granny will have to go without the bread and sweets today. Besides, I have all I can carry.
Why such a load?
Oh, I'm moving in with Granny. We had an accident too. I came home to find our house collapsed as if a big wind blew it in. I couldn't find my mother anywhere.
Oh, no.
So I salvaged what I could, and now I'm off. Oh, good friends, what news have you? What of Mother's grave? What kind of trouble? Oh, no. I can't go investigate. A princess is not supposed to go into the wood unescorted. Good idea. I'll disguise myself to go see what's wrong. Thank you, birds.
We'll take you to Granny's.
What?
We're not going to let her go alone.
Fine. I will take you.
I don't need anyone to take me. I've gone many times before.
Yes, but not when there have been such winds blowing.
Yes, we'll all take you.
No.
I'm not about to stay here with the baby when a wind might return to this house too.
I know Mother made me promise, but I'm going to find that giant anyway.
Into the woods, it's always when you think it lasts, you're through with it. Into the woods you go again to take another journey.
Into the woods, the weather's clear, we've been before, we've not to fear. Into the woods, away from here.
Into the woods to find giants.
Into the woods, to grandmother's house.
Into the woods, woods, the path is straight, no reason then to hesitate.
Into the woods, it's not so late, it's just another journey.
Into the woods, but not too long, the skies are strange, the winds are strong. Into the woods to see what's wrong.
Into the woods to slay a giant.
Into the woods to shield the child.
To flee the winds.
To find a future.
To shield.
To slay.
To flee.
To find.
To fix.
To hide.
To move.
To battle.
To see what the trouble is.
Ah! Rapunzel, what are you doing here?
Well, what's the matter?
Oh, nothing. You just locked me in a tower for 18 years of my life, blinded my prince, and banished me to a desert where I had little to eat, and again, no company. And then I bore twins. Because of the way you treated me, I will never, ever be happy.
I was just trying to be a good mother. Stay with me. There's a giant running about.
Good brother. What a surprise.
Brother, how good to see you.
What brings you into the woods today?
I am investigating news of a giant.
You investigating news of a giant? Father would not even do that. That is business for your steward, or less.
Well, what brings you into the woods?
My Rapunzel has run off.
Run off?
She's a changed woman, subject to hysterical fits of crying, moods that no soul could predict. I know not what to do.
What a pity.
And Cinderella?
She remains well.
Does she? Now, brother, do tell me what you're really doing here.
High in a tower like yours was but higher a beauty asleep. All around the tower a thicket of briar 100 feet deep. Agony, no frustration more keen. When the one thing you want is a thing that you've not even seen.
I found a casket entirely of glass. No, it's unbreakable. Inside, don't ask it, a maiden, alas. This is unwakeable,
what unmistakable.
Agony is the way always barred. She has skin white as snow.
Did you learn her name?
No, there's a dwarf standing guard.
Agony! Such that princes must weep.
Always and almost to anything, almost or something asleep.
If it were not for the thicket.
A thicket's no trick, is it thick?
It's the thickest.
The quickest is pick it apart with a stick.
Yes, but even one prick, it's my thing about blood.
Well, it's sick.
It's no sicker than your thing with dwarves.
Dwarves?
Dwarves.
Dwarves are very upsetting. Not forgetting the task unachievable. Mountains unscalable if it's conceivable. But unavailable. Their beers,
what unbearable bliss.
Agony that can cut like a knife.
Ah, well, back to my wife.
Rapunzel, I must be off. Godspeed to you, brother.
Godspeed.
After hours of searching for Granny, our intrepid travelers lost not only their way, but their patience as well.
Are you certain this is the right direction?
We went down the dell.
Perhaps you forgot the way.
The path is straight.
Was straight. Now there is no path.
Where's the stream? Where's the lily pond? Where's Granny?
Calm down. Maybe we should turn back.
No!
We will just have to find Granny's without the path.
But Mother warned me never to stray from the path.
Well, the path has strayed from you.
Wait! Look! In the distance! Three oak trees!
Yes, I recognize.
Who might that be?
It's the steward in the royal family. What brings you into the woods?
I'm on the castle.
Oh, no.
Well, I warned you. Why didn't you do something?
I don't make policy. I just carry it out.
And I warned you, you can't count on the royal family to solve your problems.
I think it best we go back to the village.
I wouldn't be in such a rush if I were you. Guess which path the giant took to the castle.
Oh, no.
What?
All that's left of my garden is a sack of beans. There's not much left of your house either.
But I heard giants never strike the same house twice.
You heard wrong.
There!
The giant's a woman!
Oh, that size!
Where is the lad who killed my husband?
There is no lad here!
Oh, we haven't seen him!
I'm at the wood on the beanstalk.
We'll get him for you right away! Don't move.
It was you who destroyed our house, not a great wind. It's because of you I'm no mother.
And now my house. That boy asked for shelter. Then he stole our gold, our hen, and our harp. Then he killed my husband and took them to our village.
But we are not responsible for him.
You're wasting your breath.
She's right. You can't reason with a dumb giant.
No giants are coming. Give me the boy.
We told you he's not here.
The girl is telling the truth.
I know he's there, and I will be right here until it's delivered to me.
The giant was nearsighted, remained convinced she had found the lad, and there was no consensus among them for us of which course of action to take.
Put a spell on her.
I no longer have my powers. If I did, you think I'd be standing here with all of you? No, we'll have to give her someone.
Who?
The steward. It's in his line of duty to sacrifice his life. And
don't be ridiculous. I'm not giving up my life for anyone.
Don't take it personally.
You must understand, these were not people familiar with making choices. Their past experiences in the woods had in no way prepared them for a force this great.
Excuse me, but would you care for a blind girl instead?
No!
How dare you! Put them out of their misery.
We're not that miserable.
What are you talking about?
She doesn't want a woman.
Fine, then what do you suggest we do?
You see, it's interesting to examine the moral issue at question here. You see, the finality of stories such as these dictates that... Sorry, I tell the story. I'm not part of it.
That's right.
Not one of us.
You're always on the outside.
You must understand, that's my role. There must always be someone on the outside.
You're going to be on the inside now.
You're making a big mistake.
Nonsense.
You need an objective observer to pass the story along.
Well, some of us don't like the way you've been telling it.
If you drag me into this mess, you'll never know how the story ends. You'll be lost.
Oh, wait. He's the only one who knows the story.
Do you think it'll be fun when you have to tell it yourselves? Think of your baby.
He's right, let him go.
A
Put that away.
Now that's better. You don't want to live in a world of chaos. There must always be someone.
Here's the lad.
I'm not the lad!
Oh, no, don't drop! Oh, why did you push him into our arms?
You wanted to get rid of him, too.
We might have thought of something else.
If it were up to you, a decision would have never been made.
Now that he's gone, we'll never know what will happen.
We'll manage.
No!
Jack was just a boy. We had no food to eat, and he sold his beloved cow in exchange for magic beans. If anyone is to be punished, it's the man who made that exchange.
That's right.
Nonsense.
He was your sovereign. Now he is punishing for his wrongs.
And we've suffered too. Do you think it was a picnic disposing of your husband's remains?
You're getting angry.
What about our anger? What about our loss? Who's been flouncing through our kingdom?
Quiet.
I'll hide my son, and you'll never find him.
Oh, don't upset the giant.
You'll never, never find him.
I'm warning you.
And if you don't go back this instant, we'll get you for all that you've done. We'll...
Ah!
Where is your son? Is that you?
No, no, this is not the boy.
Stay here.
The boy is hiding in the steeple tower.
That's true.
Yes.
If he's not, I will turn and find you.
Oh, no.
Rapunzel!
Stay away from me!
No! Don't step on him!
Oh, she's in poor condition.
Wake up.
Don't let them get Jack.
We won't.
Promise me, as I stand here at death's door.
I'll do all I can.
Promise. Promise.
All right, I promise.
No, come away from there. You killed her!
I was thinking of the greater good. That's my job.
Going to return to normal.
We must be gone if we're to arrive before midnight.
Well, where are you going?
We're off to Hanamingo.
Shh! We can't take everyone. Fools! There is nowhere to hide.
Well, you'll never get there. And we have to stay here and figure this out together.
Some people are cut out to battle giants, and others are not. I don't have the constitution, and as long as I can be of no help,
I'm going to hide.
Everything will work out just fine in the end.
Not always.
I hope the giant steps on them all.
You shouldn't say that. You were thinking the same thing.
This is terrible. We just saw three people die.
Since when are you so squeamish? How many wolves have you carved up?
A wolf's not the same.
Ask a wolf's mother.
Stop it.
I suggest we find that boy now and give her what she wants.
But if we give her the boy, she'll kill him too.
And if we don't, she'll kill half the kingdom.
One step at a time. Maybe if the boy apologizes, you know, makes amends.
Oh, yes. He'll return the stolen goods.
Yeah, he's really a sweet boy at heart. She'll see that.
You people are so blind. It's because of that boy that there's a giant in our land. Now, will you continue talking about the problem? I'll find the boy, and I'll serve him to the giant for lunch.
Are we gonna let her feed the boy to the giant?
No.
I'll have to find him first.
I'll go too.
No. You stay here with the babe.
We'll fan out. It'll increase our chances of finding him. No, not you. You stay here with the baby. I do not want you roaming through the woods.
He would leave our child with her.
The baby's asleep. He'll be safe with the girl.
Oh, but what if the giant were to return
the
here?
The giant will not return here, I know.
How are you?
I know.
But what if the...
But what if? But what if? Will only the giant's footsteps stop your argument?
You will stay here with the baby. Please.
Do you two always fight like that?
No, not really.
Seems like you do.
And there's nothing wrong with having a little argument.
Oh, I see.
Milky, Milky.
That's him. Jack! Jack!
Milky.
You stay here with the baby.
But I want to come.
No, you'll be safer here.
Don't go too far, please.
I'll only go 100 paces. If I do not find the lad, I'll come back right here. One, two, three, four, five. Jack! Jack! Hello, sir.
Hello.
You must be here to slay the giant.
Yes.
Have you come upon the giant yet?
No.
I have.
You have?
Yes.
What are you doing alone in the woods?
Well, my husband and I were actually... It's a long story.
And he would let you roam alone in the woods?
No, you see, actually, that was my choice. I'm looking for the lad.
Your choice?
Yes.
How brave.
Brave?
Yes. Anything can happen in the woods. May I kiss you? Any moment we could be crushed. Don't feel rushed.
This is ridiculous. What am I doing here? I'm in the wrong story. No. But we can't do this. You have a princess.
Well, yes, I do.
And I have a baker.
You're right. Of course. How foolish. Foolishness can happen in the woods. Once again, please. Let your hesitations be hushed. Any moment, big or small, is a moment. After all, see the moment. Skies may fall any moment.
No. But this is not right.
Right and wrong don't matter in the woods. Only
daughter's face the moment unblushed. Life is often so unpleasant. You must know that as a peasant, best you take the moment present as a present for the moment.
Jack! Jack! Oh, what's wrong, ma'am?
The tree has fallen. My mother's grave was destroyed.
Oh, I'm sorry.
My dreams have been crushed.
Oh, don't say that.
Oh, it's true. You wouldn't understand. Oh,
well, you can't stay here. There's a giant on the loose.
I'm sure that the prince will see to it that the giant is rid from our lands.
Oh, there's been no sign of the prince. No doubt he's off somewhere seducing some young maiden.
What?
Well, I understand that's what princes do.
Not all princes.
Oh, you look just like the princess, but dirty. Oh, you are the princess!
Get up, get up! I'm not a princess here.
What are you to do?
I suppose I'll be on my way back to the castle.
Well, you haven't heard. We came upon the royal family. The castle has been set upon by the giant.
And the prince?
He wasn't with them. You must come with me. You shall be safe in our company.
I must leave you.
What? Why?
The giant.
Oh, the giant. I had almost forgotten. Will we meet each other in the woods again?
Foolishness can happen in the woods. Our moment shimmering and lovely and sad. Leave the moment, just be glad for the moment that we had. Every moment is a moment when you're in the woods. Now I must go off to slay a giant. That's what the next moment holds for me. I shall not forget you, for how brave you are to be alone in the woods, and how alive you've made me feel.
What was that?
Was that me? Was that him? Did a prince really kiss me? And kiss me, and kiss me? And did I kiss him back? Was it wrong? Am I mad? Is that all? Does he miss me? Was he suddenly getting bored with me? Wake up! Stop dreaming! Stop prancing about the woods! It's not beseeming! What is it about the woods? Back to life, back to sense, back to child, back to husband. No one lives in the woods. There are vows, there are ties, there are needs, there are standards, there are shouldn'ts and shoulds. Why not both instead? There's the answer if you're clever. Have a child for warmth, and a baker for bread, and a prince for whatever.
Never! It's these woods! Face the facts, find the boy, join the group, stop the giant, just get out of these woods. Was that him? Yes, it was. Was that me? No, it wasn't. Just a trick of the woods. Just a moment. One peculiar passing moment. Must it all be either less or more, either plain or grand? Is it always or is it never? And that's what woods are for those moments in the woods. Oh, if life were made of moments, even now and then a bad one. But if life were only moments, then you never know you had one. first a witch, then a child, then a prince, then a moment who can live in the woods. And to get what you wish only just for a moment, these are dangerous woods. Let the moment go. Don't forget it for a moment, though. Just remembering you've had in and when you're back to or. Makes the or mean more than it did before. Now I understand, and it's time to leave the woods. 80, 79, 78, 77.
She should be back by now.
She said she would only go 100 paces.
I'm sure she will return.
Oh, no. I better look for her. In which direction did she go?
Look who I found.
Please don't let her give me to the giant.
It's not our fault the giant wants you.
You're hurting me.
But let go of him.
Leave him alone.
Where did you find this? Where is my wife?
She's dead.
What?
I'm sorry, sir. I came upon her. She was under a tree.
He was sobbing over her like she was his own mother.
How awful.
How could this happen?
I buried her in a footprint.
Oh, what was I thinking? I should have just stayed with her.
Remorse will get you nowhere.
Though my wife is dead.
Wake up! People are dying all around you. You're not the only one to suffer a loss. When you're dead, you're dead. Now it's time we get this boy to the giant before we're all so much dead meat.
Keep away from him!
This is no time to be soft-hearted. He's going to the giant and I'm taking him.
Oh, yes. He's the one to blame. It's because of him there's a giant in our midst and my wife is dead.
But it isn't my fault. I was given those beans. You persuaded me to trade away my cow for beans. And without those beans, there'd have been no stock to get up to the giants in the first place.
Wait a minute, magic beans for a cow so old that you had to tell a lie to sell it, which you told. Were they worthless beans? Were they oversold? Oh, and tell us who persuaded you to steal that gold.
See, it's your fault.
No.
So it's your fault.
No.
Yes, it is.
It's not.
It's true.
Wait a minute, though. I only stole the gold to get my cow back from you.
So it's your fault.
Yes.
No, it isn't. I'd have kept those beans, but our house was cursed. She made us get a cow to get the curse reversed.
It's his father's fault that the curse got placed in the place, got cursed in the first place.
Oh, then it's his fault.
So?
It was his fault.
No.
Yes, it is. It's his.
I guess.
Wait a minute, though. I chopped down the beanstalk, right? That's clear. But without any beanstalk, then what's clear is how did the second giant get down here in the first place? Second place?
Yes.
How?
Well, who had the other bean?
The other bean.
The other bean.
You pocketed the other bean.
I didn't. Yes, I did.
So it's your fault.
No, it isn't, because I gave it to my wife.
So it's her fault.
No, it isn't.
Then whose is it?
Wait a minute. She had traded that bean to obtain your shoe. So the one who knows what happened to the bean is you.
You mean that old bean that your wife... Oh, dear. Well, I never knew it, so I threw... Well, don't look here.
See, it's your fault.
But...
See, it's her fault.
But...
And it isn't mine at all.
But what?
But if you hadn't gone back up again...
We were needy.
You were greedy. Did you need that hen?
But I got it for my mother.
So it's her fault, then.
Yes, and what about the harp in the third place?
Oh, yes.
She went and dared me to.
I dared you to?
You dared me to. She said that I was scared because she dared me.
No, I didn't.
So it's your fault.
Wait a minute. You hadn't dared him to.
And you had left the harp alone.
Well, if you hadn't thrown away the bean in the first place.
Well, if she hadn't raised him in the first place.
Well, if she hadn't raised him in the first place.
Well, if she hadn't raised him in the first place.
It's your fault.
You're responsible. You're the one to blame. It's your fault.
Doesn't matter how, anyway, it doesn't matter now. It's the last midnight. It's the moon.
nothing but a vast midnight. Everybody smashed flat. Nothing we can do. Not exactly true. We could always give her the boy.
No,
of course, what really matters is the blame. Someone you can blame. Fine, if that's a thing you enjoy, placing the blame. If that's the aim, give me the blame. Just give me the boy.
No!
No. You're so nice. You're not good, you're not bad, you're just nice. I'm not good, I'm not nice, I'm just right. I'm the witch, you're the world. I'm the hitch, I'm what no one believes. I'm the witch, you're all liars and thieves. Like his father, like his son will be too. Oh, why bother? You'll just do what you do. It's the last midnight, so goodbye all. Coming at you fast, midnight. Soon you'll see the sky fall.
You want a bean? Have another bean. Beans are made for making you rich. Plant them and they soar. Hey, you want some more? Listen to the roar, giants by the score. Oh, you can blame another witch. It's the last midnight. It's the last verse. Not before it's past midnight. I'm leaving you my last curse.
I'm leaving you alone. You can tend the garden, it's yours. Separate and alone. Everybody down on all fours. All right, Mother Wen. Lost the beans again. Punish me the way you did then. Give me claws and a hunch. Just away from this bunch. And the gloom. And the doom. And the gloom.
Maybe I shouldn't have stolen from the giant.
Maybe I shouldn't have strayed from the path. Maybe I shouldn't have attended the ball.
Oh, yes. Maybe you shouldn't have.
Where are you going?
Away from here.
But you said we had to find our way out of this together.
It doesn't matter if we're together or apart.
But we need your help.
Oh, you don't understand. My wife was the only one who really helped. I depended on her for everything.
You would leave your child?
My child will be happier in the arms of a princess.
But wait! All right. Come on. Jack!
I thought you were dead.
Not completely. Are we ever?
Well, as far as I'm concerned, you are.
Is that true?
Well, it's because of you all of this happened.
I strayed into the garden to give your mother a gift. And I foolishly took some of those beans for myself. How was I to know? How are we ever to know? When she died, I ran from my guilt, and now Aren't you making the same mistake?
No.
Aren't you running away?
No more questions. Please. No more tests. Comes the day you say what for. Please. No more.
We disappoint. We disappear. We die, but we don't.
What?
They leave a mess. In turn, I fear. Forgive though they won't.
No more riddles. No more jests. No more curses you can't undo. Left by fathers you never knew. No more quests. No more feelings. Time to shut the door. Just no more.
Running away, let's do it. Free from the ties that bind. No more despair or burdens to bear out there in the yonder. Running away, go to it. Where did you have in mind? Have to take care, unless there's a where, you'll only be wandering blind. Just more questions, different kind. Where are we to go? Where are we ever to go? Running away, we'll do it. Why sit around, resign? Trouble is sun. The farther you run, the more you feel undefined. For what you have left undone, and more, what you've left behind. We disappoint, we leave a mess. We die, but we don't.
We disappoint in turn, I guess. Forget though we won't.
Like father, like son.
No more giants. Waging war. Can't we just pursue our lives with our children and our wives till that happier day arrives? How do you ignore all the witches, all the curses, all the wolves, all the lies, the false hopes, the goodbyes, the reverses? All the wondering what, even worse, is still in store. All the children. All the giants. No more.
I knew you wouldn't give up.
He wouldn't leave his baby.
It looked like he was going to.
Give me my son. He always cries when I...
Now what are we to do?
Oh, we must... must think of a plan before the giant returns.
But what?
Oh, we all have to think.
There was some way that we could surprise her.
She's too tall to surprise.
Oh, good friends, I need your help now more than ever. What of the prince? I don't care. What is important now is that we find a way to fell the giant. How can you help? You can do that? Oh, however can I thank you?
You can talk to birds.
The birds will help.
How?
When the giant returns, they'll peck her eyes out until she's blind.
What good will that do?
Well, then you can strike her, or whatever you do to kill a giant.
Once she's blinded, she'll stagger about.
She'll get angry.
She'll crush us all!
Oh, yes.
Smear the ground with pitch! We'll lure her to an area smeared with pitch. Her shoes will stick and she won't be able to move.
And I can strike her from behind.
How are you going to strike her? And from where?
Yeah, where?
A tower.
What tower?
Over there, between those two trees. An old tower.
Yeah, send her to the tower!
All right. We'll have to do something quick. The baby will be safest here with you. This will take no time.
I'm excited!
Oh, come on.
Oh, now. Shh. I know, you want your mother.
Hello.
The giant went in that direction.
My darling, I did not recognize you. What are you doing in those old clothes? And with a child. You must get back to the castle at once. There's a giant on the loose.
The giant has been to the castle.
No. Are you all right? My love, why are you being so cold?
Maybe because I am not your only love. Am I?
I love you. I do. But yes, it's true.
Why? Why, if you love me, would you have strayed?
I thought if you were mine that I would never have wished for more. And part of me is content and as happy as I've ever been. But there remains a part of me that continually needs more.
I have on occasion wanted more. That does not mean I went in search of it. If this is how you behave as a prince, what kind of king would you be?
I was raised to be charming, not sincere. I didn't ask to be born king, and I am not perfect. I am only human.
I think you should go.
Leave? But I do love you.
Consider that I have been lost, a victim of the giant.
Is that what you really wish?
My father's house was a nightmare, and your house was a dream. And now I want something in between. Please, just go.
I shall always love the maiden who ran away.
And I, the faraway prince.
They're almost finished. You see over there between those two trees? When the giant comes, we're to send her over there.
Good.
I wanted to climb the tower, too.
I'm glad you're here to help me. What's wrong?
My granny's gone.
Oh, no. I'm so sorry.
I think my mother and my grandmother would be very upset with me.
Why?
Because they said to always make them proud. And here I am about to kill somebody.
Not somebody. A giant who has been doing harm.
But the giant's a person. Aren't we to show forgiveness? Mother would be very disappointed with these circumstances.
Mother cannot guide you. Now you're on your own. Only me beside you. Still you're not alone. No one deceive you. You decide what's good. You decide alone. But no one is alone.
I wish.
I know.
Wait until my mother hears I've slain the giant.
Jack, your mother is dead.
Dead? Was she killed by the giant?
Well, she was arguing with the giant, trying to protect you, and was struck a deadly blow by the prince's steward.
No, why would he do that?
He was afraid she was provoking the giant.
Can no one bring her back?
No one.
That steward will pay for this. After we slay the giant, I will slay him.
Well, you'll do no such thing.
But he shouldn't have killed my mother, right?
Well, I guess not.
Then he must die.
Well, no.
Why not?
Because that would be wrong.
What he did was wrong. He should be punished.
He will be, somehow.
How?
I don't know. Stop asking me questions I can't answer.
I'm going to kill him.
Oh, then kill him. No. No, don't kill him.
Mother isn't here now.
Things, right things.
Who knows what she'd say?
Who can say what's true?
Nothing's quite so clear now.
Do things, fight things.
Feel you've lost your way.
You decide, but
you,
you are not alone.
Believe me, no one is
no
alone.
No one is alone, believe me.
Truly,
you move just a finger.
Something's bound to linger.
Be heard. No one acts alone. Careful, no one is alone. People make mistakes. Fathers,
mothers,
people make mistakes.
Holding to their own. Honor their mistakes.
Fight for their mistakes.
Everybody makes
one another's terrible mistakes. Witches can be right. Giants can be good.
You decide what's right. You decide what's good. Just remember.
Someone is on your side.
Our side.
Someone else is not.
While we're seeing our side,
maybe we forgot.
They are not alone. No one is alone. Hard to see the light now.
Just don't let it go. Things will come out brighter.
Shall leave your kingdom.
Oh, God!
spoon can catch the potato.
Every knot was one straight rope.
The harder to wake, the better to have.
Ah, excuse me.
When going to hide, know how to get there.
And how to get back.
And eat first.
The knife that is sharp today may be dull by tomorrow.
Last, and now we can all return home, and let us hope there will be no more killing.
Where am I to go? I have no one to take care of me.
You'll have to take care of yourself now, Jack. It's time.
No, it's not. I'll take care of him.
You will?
Yes. I'll be your mother now.
I don't want another mother. I want a friend. And a pet.
Of course. We have nowhere to go, so we'll move in with you.
Oh, no.
It'll be fun.
My house is in shambles, and there's hardly any room for... Of course, you can come home with us.
And you shall join us, too.
Oh, you'll not return to the castle.
I'll gladly help you with your house. There are times I actually enjoy cleaning. And how proud your wife would have been of you.
How sad it is that my son will never know her. Well, maybe I just wasn't meant to have children.
Don't say that. Of course you were meant to have children.
But how will I go about being a father with no one to mother my child?
Just calm the child.
Yes, calm the child.
Look, tell him the story of how it all happened. Be father and mother. You'll know what to do.
Alone.
Sometimes people leave you halfway through the war. Do not let it grieve you. No one leaves for good. You are not alone. No one is alone. Hold him to the now, let him see the glow. Things will be all right now. Tell him what you know.
Shh, shh. Once upon a time, in a far off kingdom, there lived.
Careful of the things you say.
Maiden.
Children will listen.
Sad young lad.
Careful the things you do.
And a childless
children
thinker.
Will see.
With his wife.
And learn. Children may not obey, but children will listen. Children will look to you.
Those deep, those dark, and the pain, the path we may encounter. Into the woods, but not too slow.